We weren't sure at the morning skate whether CeCe would go. He got the approval from head athletic trainer T.D. Forrest and played the game. And now here's McDavid's first shift to the net. Centering pass, and it went off Lapping, and he scores. McDavid needs all of 5 seconds to make it 1-0. Welcome back, Captain.
Wasn't in the warm-up before the game, and this is his first touch of the ice. Outstanding. Outlet pass up the ice on the tape, and he just drives it into the zone. Gets a little bit of a bounce here.
So now, Henrique moves into the circle, replacing McDavid. Wins the draw cleanly back to Kulak's shot, and Henrique scores on the rebound. Right what you talked about on the onset of our telecast, Louis. Adam Henrique planting himself just outside the blue paint and burying his 24.
For this faceoff here, it's Henrique that steps in. So he steps in and wins the draw. And then a little wrist that goes off the body of a shark in front, drops down in front of Henrique, and he jams it home. But guess what happens? After the faceoff, you move yourself to the net. All three Oilers.
Points in 11 straight for the Sharks. That's the third longest active streak in the league right now. Henry Thrun reversing. Corey Perry's going to pick that one off. He's got Holloway. Instead, McLeod shoots off the crossbar. Rebound slid out the other side. Perry deflected it. Now Burrows. Wrist shot. That one off a boot. And it was Burrows with the ill-fated icing call that set up Edmonton's second goal. Here's a breakout. Fogle shoots and scores. 3-0. Warren Fogle. His 18th. And Edmonton shelling the Sharks.
And a great decision here for Fogle. You've got the wide open lane in the net. Take it. Great work by Dreisaitl, the defensive zone. Good pressure by Edmonton. The one-handed feat, Dreisaitl to Fogle. He's got Nugent Hopkins as a left-handed option on the right-hand side. This is the battle won. He gets the inside track on Burrows, and then the one-handed pass to Fogle. Primary assist on this.
Mackenzie Blackwood, who beat Edmonton back in November, did not make the trip. He's been banged up. Here's Henrique. Back door. Score! Dylan Holloway. His second goal since being called up from Bakersfield. And his fifth of the season. Edmonton extends to a 4-0 lead.
With McDavid and Dreisaitl up on that line. Throw this combination out. But this is just good work down low. And something that Dylan Holloway talked about playing with Corey Perry. He says, you don't have a play, kid. Put it down low. Continue to cycle. Continue to have possession of the puck. And it pays off with a beautiful pass from Henrique to Holloway in the slot. After they cycle it around a couple of times, find that sweet spot.
Backing up tonight, by the way, is Georgi Romanov. Here's McDavid breaking in. Right to Dent. Rattled around. Still loose. The Sharks able to keep it out of their own net.
He never even looked at that puck, but why would he?
He wasn't shooting under any circumstances. And then backhander, short side. That's going to be Daniil Dushan with his first National Hockey League goal.
The American Hockey League for the Barracuda before being recalled. And they said he plays with some jam. Nice little swim move here as he chops it by, swims around, and then just from a sharp angle gets this puck, and good things happen. It's a little bit of a fluky one that knuckles through, goes off the pad somehow.
Following Dushan, able to squeak one through Skinner. Back home to Bouchard. Dreisaitl redirected behind to score. Fogle muscles at home, 5-1.
And this is just sticking with it. Warren Fogle eventually will jam this home, but it's the work in the corners once again. There's a good puck battle. Looks like it's going to get out. This has happened way too many times early for the San Jose Sharks. They have just not been able to get that puck out of their zone. Redirected en route to the net by Nugent Hopkins, and Fogle stays with it. Good job to be around the blue paint and bash in the rebound.
Great backtrack by McDavid to get all the way back. That was a tap in for Granlund. At least would have had a real high quality chance.
Zach Hyman looking for Adam Henrique. His shot redirected off the post. Somehow that stayed out. Gretzky did 11 straight times between 81 and 91. Nurse fanned on it. Jemmonti Smith breakaway. Yeah, Stuart Skinner. In the slot for Dylan Holloway. Off to Ekholm. Centering pass. That was whipped out the other side by Ryan McLeod. Got through Gushin. Perry tried to drag it out in front, knocked away.
There's another guy that can work the walls, isn't he? Corey Perry just loves being in there.
Centering pass. What a save by Cooley. His best of the night. Robbing Holloway of what would have been his second goal of the night. Holloway, a dart. Bouchard. Perry taps it home. Next one. Beautiful three-way passing play, and Corey Perry has a dozen this year.
Milan, this is the line since Holloway's been recalled from Bakersfield they put together. Two speedy guys with a grizzled, cagey veteran. Beautiful. Behind the back pass on that one, you mentioned it, Cooley fends that one off, but then they go to work again. Use the wall, chip it in deep, beautiful cross path, Holloway. The better one is Bouchard finds Perry, who's just kind of worked his way out at the right time. He stops at first, gems at home. He's
also was on that World Cup gold medal winning team 2 years later. McDavid, a lead pass for Zach Hyman. Vlasic is back. Hyman to Henrique in front. Punto brilliantly. What a finish. Driving the net. Cody Ceci with his fifth of the year. And it's 7-1.
Just a good play out of the zone here. You're going to see McDavid puts it up the middle. Nice job by Hyman. Gained some space. Little stop up. Henrique with a beautiful feed into CeCe. And we talked about this experiment, putting Henrique with McDavid and Hyman. And it's worked out very well in this game. So something they wanted to tinker with. And now up 7-1. That beautiful redirection by CeCe on a sweet pass from Henrique.
Henrique, a three-point night. CeCe's fifth for Hyman and Henrique. Here's Corey Perry looking to make it 8-1. Dishes, score! And Bouchard finishes. Cooley down and out. And the Oilers' lead increases to a touchdown.
Onoff's going to step in there, as you mentioned, and rightfully so. You saw this the last start. Edmonton against the San Jose Sharks. They came out storming, and again here, just run Cooley right out of the nets, and he doesn't want to come out. He's on his knee in there, but it's 8-1 here. Still with 6:11 left the second period. Great patience here by Perry, and then he threads it through to...
Right now, the Sharks have passed Atlanta. This is now the worst goal differential by an NHL club since the 94 Senators. McDavid walks in, dishes. There it is! 100 assists! Connor McDavid setting up Hyman's 54th goal! The century mark! Edmonton 9-1.
Congratulations, Connor, on another unbelievable milestone for yourself and your team. And guess who? So fitting that a Zach Hyman is number one target all year long to jam this one home.
Two games left for Edmonton. Two more opportunities to talk and shuffle combinations, as Louis's talking about here. Scrambling on a two-on-one. Drag move, Wade shoots, save Skinner, rebound of the blue paint, score! 9-2. Sharks get one back.
He's come back like this, and for Desharnais, it's kind of tied up in the middle of the ice. It's a little pickpocket by Granlund. He sets it in motion. Nugent Hopkins takes that away. Great patience by Granlund. As you mentioned, there's one stop made on an attempted play in tight, and then eventually it finds its way through. As you see, Zetterlund eventually
chipped safely out by Stern. Here's an opportunity brewing for Portillo, and he fired it through the middle at the horn. And Edmonton